Welcome to my talk. My name is Josef van Wyngaard from Voermalt Feeds, technical manager there. And today we're going to talk about the transition ewe. That's from late gestation or late pregnancy right through to lambing to the first 30 days of lactation. Now to kick off, we're going to look at the nutritional requirements of the ewe. Now that's right through her production cycle from flush feeding, where we start preparing the ewe for mating. And then we assume the ewe is pregnant, right up to lambing stage, and then weaning at the end of the day. Now where the transition ewe window fits in, it's 6 weeks before lambing, right up to 4 weeks after lambing. So it's a small window, but extremely important, as you can see on the graph, where the nutritional requirement of the ewe is at its peak during this stage. Now if we take a further look at the nutritional requirements of the ewe, where I did a little comparison, we look at protein requirement and energy requirement, and I did a comparison with a ewe in maintenance, a late gestation, specifically a ewe carrying twins, and then early lactation, a ewe with twin lambs. Alright, so the first thing that's evident there is protein requirement jumps up from 85 grams per day to 180 grams during late gestation. And then it jumps up to 300 grams per day during early lactation. And then the same with the energy requirement. Starts off with 0.6 kilograms per day. That goes up to 1.15 and as high as 1.25 there at early lactation at the end of the day. So that's a significant increase. We're talking about a protein increase by 3.5 folds and the energy increase by twofolds from maintenance right up to the peak nutritional requirement during this transition phase of the ewe. Now, why is this phase so important, specifically the late gestation or late pregnancy phase? Well, we know that 75% of lamb growth occurs during this stage. Also, there's wool follicle development happening there with the lamb. So that will affect the quality and the amount of wool produced by the lamb before it's born. And then also we've got other development there happening with the ewe. So there's a lot of stuff happening, and we know that research shows that body condition score must be correct during this stage, because otherwise you're going to sit with a low survival percentage of lambs at the end of the day. Now we've got one challenge during this phase, or problem, and that's rumen space. All right, so roughage only is not sufficient anymore. We need to up the quality of the feed, so we need to feed a high quality concentrate with low quality roughage, or we need to feed a complete feed of high quality at the end of the day. Now the recommended complete feed or lick that Voermalt supplies will be first, if you look at a TMR, that's a total mixed ration or complete feed, or a third name would be your lambing pen mixture. So it also contains a grain component of about 400 kilograms. That's milled maize or whole small crops. And then we include Voermalt Maximal Concentrate. That would be our concentrate containing all the minerals, your urea component, as well as your bypass protein component. And then we need to include roughage because it's a complete feed. So we can include high quality roughage. It will be milled lucerne at 400 kilograms. And then also we need to include HPC, high protein concentrate, and that would be Voermalt ProCon 33, 50 kilograms at the end of the day. Expected intakes, we need to adapt the animal, so we can't just supply the animal in full amounts of this lambing pen mixture. So we start off 2 weeks prior lambing. We adapt the animals with 500 grams of this complete feed with additional roughage on the side. 1 week prior lambing, we can supply the animal with about 1 kilogram of this complete feed with additional roughage on the side. And at point of lambing, we supply unrestricted amount of this lambing pen mixture or complete feed, where we remove the additional roughage on the side. The second option would be to supply a production lick. It also contains a grain component, which will be your energy component of 500 kilograms. And then we include 400 kilograms of the Voermalt Maximal Concentrate. You can include coarse salt at about 5 or 10%, so on a ton mixture, you'll include 50 kilograms to 100 kilograms of coarse salt. Intakes there, we will start off at 150 grams per ewe per day, and that would be 6 weeks before lambing. So we start off 150, and each week as we get closer to lambing, we increase the production lick intake, so that we end at more or less 600 grams of this lick per ewe per day during the last week before she starts lambing. Right, and more about this product specifically, we talked about Maxivol Concentrate, Procon 33. So Maxivol Concentrate is also registered with the Animal Feed Act as a protein, mineral and trace mineral concentrate, specifically for sheep and goats, with a registration number V4985. And it contains various natural protein sources. It's got a total protein content of 35%, of which only 57.9% is derived from MPN sources, that's your non-protein nitrogen sources, such as urea. And with that low inclusion of urea, we're actually preventing viscous colostrum prior lambing at the end of the day. And it also contains high levels of magnesium, which is a macro mineral, and that prevents dystocia. Dystocia is just difficult lambing. So we're easing the lambing process and making the ewe more healthy at the end of the day so that she can recover quicker after lambing. And then also it contains high levels of trace minerals, which stimulates appetite because we know intake is a problem during late pregnancy, so we're stimulating appetite, and we're strengthening the immune system to ensure quick recovery after lambing. And then there's various uses of Furmal Maxivol Concentrate. We can start off with a maintenance lick during your, let's say, your early gestation or pregnancy period, moving over to a production lick on various roughage systems. So if you've got higher quality roughage systems, then you just change your mixture, you increase your energy component compared to your Furmal Maxivol Concentrate inclusion. And then also we can make complete feeds such as the lambing pen mixture as mentioned previously. We can make several different dairy meals for the dairy industry, also mainly due to this high bypass protein composition of Furmal Maxivol Concentrate. So at the end of the day, with the use of Furmal Maxivol Concentrate, we're stimulating udder development, we're stimulating wool and fiber development of the lamb before it's born, and then also we stimulate colostrum and milk production to ensure healthy lambs, strong lambs, and then also it ensures a maximum winning percentage at the end of the day. Furmal Procon 33, also registered with the Animal Feed Act as a protein concentrate for ruminants. So that would be cattle, sheep, goats, wildlife as well. And then we can also use it for horses, pigs, etc. So it's the only 4-in-1 high protein concentrate on the market. It contains 33% total protein, of which 0% is derived from NPN, so it does not contain urea. So it's safe for horses and pigs, etc. It contains a minimum of 3 natural protein sources. It's got a high quality bypass protein, which is essential for young animals or high producing animals, such as the transition ewe. And then also it contains macro and trace minerals for the immune system and normal function of the immune system. And then also it supplies vitamin A and vitamin E in ample amounts. And it's got a good energy component, so it does not dilute the energy in a ration when you include Procon 33. To conclude, for more information, please give me a call at 082-33-60626 or send an email to josef.vanweingaard@tongaard.com or visit our website or our Facebook page for more information. Thank you for your time.